definitely up for this. This is... Sorry, I'm looking over my shoulder at my games collection, because this is in my games collection. So far out of my games collection, we have played Aladdin, Alien 3, Elisa Dragoon, Altered Beast, Atomic Robo Kid. Yes, I have the Japanese card. Don't know how rare it is, I got it for £4. Pretty good, I thought. Batman, Sunsoft one. The movie one. And next on the list is this, Blades of Vengeance. Awesome game. Don't get me wrong, limited in places and a little bit rubbish in places. I'll give you examples of that now. I like using her or him, but it turns out you can only rarely beat the game with him. Those two are rubbish, basically because they have short range weapons. I'll give you an example of how this guy is better. So imagine with those guys, you're basically swinging your axe or sword about. I've never really leveled up with them because I didn't realise until I used this guy that the power-ups are actually really effective. Now, last year sometime, maybe the year before, when I got my Mega Drive, I got this quite early with it. And I got into it for like a week. I played this pretty much non-stop. That said, I will have forgotten pretty much everything now. So you'll have to bear with me while it all comes back. Somewhere down here is a Prezi. Is it actually through there? Oh no. Oh, I didn't really want to do that. Well, there's a Prezi. I wanted to go up. Oh yeah. Oh, that's alright. I think I can go through that door there. Yes. And another Prezi. Alright, so that's money. But there's power-ups. And you can see I've got this rubbish little starry thing. It'll come back to me, don't worry. There's something you pick up that is basically a power-up. So this is like an action platformer at first. Well, it is all the way through, but at first it's just that, quite simple. The thing is, it's much better than it initially comes across, this game. It's well designed. And it does come across as well designed, actually, doesn't it? It doesn't really look like a badly designed game. I mean, in terms of layouts, of course, and actual game mechanics, not in terms of visuals. I can't believe how much this game I've forgotten, considering how much I played it last year. Oh, the year before. Ah, yeah, I remember you. There we go. Yummy. Now, I'm sure there's some special stuff lying about here somewhere. I had this, you know when you have like a game map totally in your head, and every time you play it, you just automatically do it? Well, that was the case for a while, but it's totally gone from my head now. I know I'm missing stuff, and I'm missing power-ups, like essential power-ups. But we're going to have to just live with that, because let's face it, this isn't a full playthrough, this is like a 10-minute go. I'm going to get as far as I can with this dude in that time. I don't think I'll die. I should actually make it a fair way through the game in that time. I'm just swine. But I need that power up. Where is it? It's here somewhere. But I know you're here somewhere. I can smell you. Oh yeah. Oh, nasty man. Oh yes, I've got a good feeling. Uh-oh. Yes. See, now it's gone from twinkly stars, these big round swirly things. They're like twice as powerful. I can take out those dudes with swords now a little bit easier. But let's go this way. Oh, that was silly. I knew there was fire here somewhere, but I thought I was being smart and avoiding it. But no, uh-oh, fireman. Yeah, uh-oh, more firemen. Is that it? Is that all your firemen that you've got for me? Yeah. See, I'd totally forgotten about fireman until he just attacked me then. In fact, this is where I'm meant to be going. Because usually, you go this way and he gets you from behind. With that dude as well. So actually, accidentally did pretty well there. But see, you can see how this game is all designed. It's all laid out in such a way as... Ooh. Oh no. It's the challenger. Oh, that's the end of the level and all. No way have I just died. Oh, I've lost me thing. Oh, well, doesn't that suck, the fat one? Right. And it took a lot of that last year, and then I started getting to the point where I could do this level with my eyes closed. Except now I can't, because I've forgotten it all clearly. Oh no, my little power-up's gone. Lesson learned, boys and girls. Don't die. I mean, that is a life lesson right there if ever you need one. But in terms of this game as well, which is clearly how I meant it. There we go. Okay, we're just going to blast through now because we've lost our power up. But basically, you keep powering that up until it's like pretty monstrous and really effective. But what I love about this game is, see the way he's wearing like old grey, well, brown, tattered robes. Oh, that's a power up as well. If I pause it, yeah, there you go. Look, invisibility. Force field, blast. That's for a boss later. But yeah, see, I'm wearing like those robes. And it took me just to figure that pause menu thing off. I'm wearing those robes later on. His robes develop and become like smarter. And he looks dead cool. And that must, I'm assuming that happens to the other characters too. Which would be brilliant. I wonder what they look like in the next levels. Unfortunately, the game is not that well balanced for the other characters. And you don't really get to see them powered up, at least I haven't yet. And I've got pretty good at this game in the time. I mean, check that out. Talking and doing that bit, that was pretty cool. I don't mean to brag, but I am quite pleased with that little effort. I was not finding a pain in the rear end. There's something good over here, I'm sure of it. I'm sure of it. Uh-oh. No, this is something bad. I want something good. Ow! Oh no, don't kill me on that. Oh come on. Should have just kept walking, shouldn't I? Silly Michael. Oh, that's kind of where I was up to, I think. Oh, fireman. I've totally forgotten how to play this game in like 1 year. Oh, that's just a silly way to die. Oh, that is a silly way to die. See, it does stuff like that to you when you're a noob, not when you're a seasoned professional wizard. Oh, I'm getting battered. Oh, doesn't that suck, the fat one? It really does. Damn shame, because I'm much better at this game than that. I've seen quite a lot of it. And I was hoping to show off and brag, but hey, that's the way the cookie crumbles. But don't let that put you off. Blades of Vengeance, in my opinion, is one of the top 50 Mega Drive games. I allow myself 50 Mega Drive games at any one time. If I want to buy a new one, I have to replace an old one. That's how it works. Now, excuse me, I have a cold. But to continue my point, Blades of Vengeance is one of those games that was in my collection, my recent collection from quite early on, because I know how good it is. And it's one of those games that won't be swapped out anytime soon. Blades of Vengeance, Sega Mega Drive, awesome game. Thanks for watching.